Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, we shall discuss some non-typical changes in state of matter and the latent heat involved. In a typical change in state of matter, the temperature of the substance remains unchanged. Consider the familiar cooling curve. This represents two typical changes in state of matter. In the first phase change, the gas condenses into a liquid at boiling point. The temperature is constant during the condensation. In the second phase change, the liquid freezes into a solid at melting point. The temperature is also constant during freezing. According to its definition, latent heat is the change in energy of an object when it undergoes a phase change without a change in temperature. Based on this, we can measure the latent heat of fusion by measuring the energy supply when an object is changed from solid to liquid. Here, the melting point can be identified easily because the temperature remains unchanged during melting. We shall discuss in detail about this experiment in the coming videos. However, the world is not so simple. In some cases, a liquid may remain in liquid form below the melting point. That is, it may freeze at a temperature other than the melting point. For example, it is possible to cool water below 0 degrees Celsius. This is called supercooled water. You can try this experiment at home. Place a bottle of distilled water inside the freezer at minus 8 degrees Celsius. After about 2.5 hours without disturbing the water, don't even open the door of the refrigerator. Then, carefully take it out of the refrigerator. You may get a bottle of supercooled water. This bottle of liquid water is below 0 degrees Celsius. When you shake the bottle or pour the water onto some ice or put some ice into the bottle, the liquid will turn into ice immediately. Scientists explain this phenomenon by the fact that a phase change always starts with some nucleation. Supercooled water lacks of this nucleation. However, impurities or a disturbance will produce nucleation, causing the supercooled water to freeze quickly. We are going to study supercooled water experimentally and the latent heat involved. The apparatus used in this experiment include a clean test tube, a thermometer, a beaker of crusted ice, some salt, a bottle of distilled water, and a dry cloth. Add the salt into the beaker of the crusted ice to produce a sub-zero mixture. The temperature of this mixture can be as low as minus 20 degrees Celsius. Half fill the test tube with distilled water. Insert the thermometer into the test tube. Insert the test tube into the mixture. Leave the test tube alone without disturbing it and watch the temperature falls. If you are lucky, the temperature will continue to fall passing 0 degrees Celsius without a pause. Then, you may get supercooled water at minus 4 degrees Celsius. Supercooled water is highly unstable because water should have turned into ice if nucleation exists. Any impurities adding into it will turn the water into ice immediately. Now, add a piece of ice into the supercooled water. This will cause the water to freeze into solid ice quickly. Before we go on, I would like to ask you to guess what happened to the temperature when the supercooled water is turned into ice. Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Please press the space bar to pause the video now and write down your answer. When a piece of ice is added into the supercooled water, the temperature rises from minus 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Can you explain this result in terms of latent heat? Again, pause the video for a while now and answer the question. Please press the space bar to pause the video and write down your answer. According to the cooling curve, latent heat of fusion is released from water as it freezes into ice. For ordinary freezing, this takes place slowly so that the latent heat is slowly released from the water and the mixture of ice and water will remain at 0 degrees Celsius during the whole freezing process. However, when a supercooled water freezes, it will take place quickly. As a result, the latent heat released from the water will heat up the mixture. Therefore, the temperature of the water-ice mixture increases from minus 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. In fact, supercooled liquid is used in heat pads. A heat pad consists of liquid sodium acetate trihydrate and a coin inside a plastic bag. The liquid is supercooled. Do you think the melting point of sodium acetate is above the room temperature or below the room temperature? Pause the video for a while now and answer the question. Please press the space bar to pause the video now and write down your answer. The melting point of sodium acetate trihydrate is 58 degrees Celsius. Normally, sodium acetate trihydrate is in the form of solid crystal. Therefore, liquid sodium acetate is a supercooled liquid. This is explained by the absence of nucleation during the cooling. When a piece of crystal is added to the supercooled liquid or a disturbance is produced, it will freeze immediately. According to the cooling curve, latent heat of fusion will be released in a short period of time. This explains why when the coin is squeezed, the heat pad will get warm. Another phenomenon involving latent heat in a short period of time is fire extinguisher. A fire extinguisher consists of liquid carbon dioxide under very high pressure. Under standard atmospheric pressure, carbon dioxide is a gas. However, it can be liquefied by applying a very high pressure. When a fire extinguisher is released, the liquid carbon dioxide will turn into a gas quickly. Since a change from liquid to gas requires absorption of latent heat of vaporization, it will absorb a large amount of energy from the surroundings as well as the carbon dioxide itself. Therefore, the gas coming out of the fire extinguisher is very cold. It is so cold that the water vapor in air will condense into water drops immediately. This explains why mists are often observed when a fire extinguisher is used. Also, dry ice can be produced if a piece of cloth is wrapped around the mouth of the fire extinguisher. Note that the reason for the cooling of carbon dioxide gas is also explained by the expansion of the gas. According to physics, when a gas expands, work is done by the gas against the external pressure. Therefore, expansion will cool a gas. Since the explanation involves concepts which you have not yet learned, it is sufficient to explain this phenomenon by the absorption of latent heat of vaporization alone. Besides using a fire extinguisher, we can demonstrate this by using a butane canister. Similar to a fire extinguisher, the canister consists of liquefied butane gas under high pressure. Under standard atmospheric pressure, butane is a gas. Do you think the boiling point of butane is above room temperature or below room temperature? Pause the video for a while now and answer the question. Please press the spacebar to pause the video now and write down your answer. The boiling point of butane is 1 degree Celsius only. Therefore, liquid butane will boil at room temperature. It tends to vaporize. We call such a liquid a volatile liquid. However, besides being volatile, butane is highly flammable. Therefore, do not try this experiment at home without adult supervision. In summary, you have learned some non-typical changes of state of matter. Non-typical means that the change of state occurs at a varying temperature rather than at melting point or at boiling point. For example, a supercooled liquid will heat up itself when it freezes. This is explained by the release of latent heat of fusion in a short period of time. Another example is liquefied gas will cool itself when it vaporizes. This is explained by the absorption of latent heat of vaporization in a short period of time. Question: do you think evaporation will produce a cooling effect or a heating effect? Please explain your answer in terms of latent heat. Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. I hope this video can help you understand more about latent heat. Thank you for watching.